Judah and Dan are linked up together some kind of way. You have to also look at how's he the serpent, by the way, also. So the Black Americans are Judah, so he's off on that. Of course, Black Americans aren't going to be Judah because, you know, him and his people are Judah. You know what I mean? So of course he's not going to be Judah. But Don Bala is envisioned, like you see here, he is envisioned as a snake, as a serpent. So they do call him a serpent. Okay? And he's a false god that they worship. I thought it was Don Bala, but it looks like they saying it's Dambala, D-A-M. Now what I was going to say also, pertaining to Dan and Dahomey, is that I forget now. Okay, that answer your question. But you got to go by the prophecies, not by, you know, what they speculate things to be. It has to go by the prophecies. Okay. So the prophecies tell us what Dan is going to be doing, and as well as he has to remember also that Dan was taken north. That's why the Bible tells us Dan shall judge himself as his people as one tribe of Israel, because they had different factions of them. Some factions had to reunite and had to have something unique about their oneness that no other tribe has. And what's unique about their oneness is that they have the same heroes, the same myths, the same legend, and they have the same identification with each other as red and black, even though they red or light skin and dark skin, darker and lighter, they still call themselves, you know, one people. And they still have the same, they still have a lot of the same heroes. Isaiah 25:19, read that, going back to the spices. Ezekiel 25:19, read that. Wait, go back. Ezekiel 27:19. Ezekiel, you see 28 right there, I mean this one is 27. Ezekiel 27. It'll start from 17.
For Judah is and the land of...
Let me see. I read it because some of the words might be a little longer, okay? So it says, Judah and the land of Yasha'Allah, they were merchants, okay? They were thy merchants. They traded in thy market wheat of minith and panad and honey and oil and balm. Damascus was thy merchant, and the multitude of the wares of thy making for the multitude of thy riches, and the wine of Hebron and white wool. Okay, I'll go to verse 19. All right, read.
Dan and Javan,
which is the ancient, which is one of the Greek islands. So Dan was chilling with Javan. So Dan also and Javan, read.
Going to and fro occupied and
going to and fro, what does that mean? Dan is on the land. What does to and fro mean? Javan is in the water. To and fro how? Through the waters, on ships. They going back and forth on ships from Dan, Israel, to Syria, okay? Tyre and Zidon, to Kittim, to Javan. Remember, the scripture already said that Dan was occupied. Why did Dan stay on ships? So on these ships, they were going to and fro. Read.
Occupied in thy fairs. Bright iron, acacia.
Bright what?
Acacia.
No, read it again. You said something about iron?
Con.
Read it again.
To and fro, occupied in thy fairs. Bright iron.
Spell iron.
I-R-O-N.
So iron, go ahead.
Acacia.
Acacia, which is like a spice herb. Very expensive spice herb. Similar to, it's very similar to cinnamon. Okay. The okay, the essential oil right here. Well, let's go to doTERRA. On doTERRA.com, they have what size is this? 15 ml, which is about what, 1.5 ounces? Okay, because 15 ml. I think 15 ml is 1 ounce. Okay. Okay, so this is 3/4 of an ounce then, which is not a lot of liquid, but it's Acacia, a close relative of cinnamon, as a wonderful fragrant, was a wonderful fragrant, and thousands of years of historical use mentioned in the Old Testament. Acacia has literally been used for its fragrance and calming properties. So that's an acacia. Okay, what was the other one? Huh? Yeah, like bark of a tree.
Acacia wood.
Uh-huh. Acacia wood was used by Israel also. You said for what?
Wasn't it used to build the ark too?
I think so. No, gopher. They call it gopher wood, I think. Acacia was used, I think, in the construction of the temple or something. What's the next one?
And calamus.
Calamus, C-A-L-A-M-U-S. It might be like a sweet grass, I'm not sure. Say calamus.
C-A-L-A-N-U-S.
Calamus. Okay, it's like, I think it's like a sweet.
Sweet flag.
Swimming grass family. Calamus root extract, 10. Calamus root, $5 or something. I don't know how much the quantity of that is. Of course, calamus. It's called sweet flag. You said, yes, was it a grass?
No, not
a
cane.
Mm. I gotta get, what is, look like it's a grass. Okay. So anyway, so calamus and what else?
And acacia were in thy market.
So it said bright iron, calamus, bright iron, acacia, and calamus. Is that the end of the verse?
Were in thy market.
Okay, so Dan was bringing these things back and forth. So these are different spices that Dan was bringing back and forth. That's why we said now, when we look at the scripture, we see that Dan was bringing these different spices, so much so that it's talked about in the scriptures. Now we see when we go into the modern times that Spice Island, where Grenada was at, you know, was being occupied by the so-called Indians in the East, including also the white man didn't just come in and plant these spices there. When he got there, the spices were already there, being cultivated and harvested by the Danites that were there. You understand? So the same thing they did on the eastern side of the waters, they did on the western side of the waters, meaning they were, you know, getting these spices and trading and buying and selling these different things. So you have all these different aspects of Dan's existence on the eastern Caribbean that followed them in the eastern hemisphere. They followed them over into the Western Hemisphere also. Okay. You have the leaping from Bashan. You have the seamanship, and then you have the dealing with the different spices. Then you have like leaping from Bashan, but also going from so many different places. Okay. East Caribbean, well, South America to Trinidad, Trinidad to all the islands, including the Grenadines, and up to the Lucayo up in the Bahamas, and then going over to Roatan. Roatan come over into Honduras and Belize, and then come up into the Americas, entering through the merchant marines. So much so that it was like in large portions they were doing these things. You might find one or two Jamaican sailors or Panamanian sailors, but it was a lot of the Garifuna that was saying, I want to be in these merchant marines on these big ships across the waters and oceans. Everybody understand? So that's how we see that these people are the tribe of Dan. Because out of all the different 12 tribes breakdowns, none of them have the Garifuna on them. Everybody says the Garifuna are West Indies or Benjamin. But if you talk to a Benjamite and ask him if he's a Garifuna, he's going to say no. If you ask a Garifuna if he's a West Indian, he's going to say no. If you ask a Garifuna if he's Creole and like Belize, he's going to say no. They have a different history, different culture, different background, different language. Benjamin is so assimilated into Western society, his culture, his music, his sounds revolve around Western cultural outlets that he learned in slavery and then reproduced it back in the form of reggae music, but with modern instruments. Dan's music is ancient. He's turtle shells, animal skin drums, conch shells, and uses the lyrics and the words that are ancient from his own tongue, not through English or through a patois or through a Creole English like how they speak in Jamaica, Belize, Trinidad, Guyana, Grenada, Dominica. His is more rooted in the ancient ways of his ancestors, which is he has a pre-colonial culture that he's very knowledgeable of and very expressive with. Okay, with which he's very expressive. Benjamin does not have that. Benjamin has elements of pre-colonial culture and history and identification, but it only just happens to be there. So they don't consider themselves to be the same people. Okay? They don't consider themselves to be the same people. Benjamites don't speak an Arawak language. The Arawaks, the Indians speak an Arawak language, not the Benjamites. These are Arawak or Danite people, but their language is still a Danite language. And they still speak like Danites speak. Everybody understand? Even more so than the other ones in Dominica and Trinidad. Their native dialect is even more rich than the other people that look lighter skinned than them, that might look like her as opposed to like me. Okay, so they're still there. So people want to just say, well, this is Benjamin. It's not Benjamin. Okay? The scriptures about Benjamin do not fit the Garifuna. He did not tear the spoil, divide the spoil at night. Okay? He does not dwell as a wolf in lone packs or lone groups, lone wolf. So Benjamin's attributes don't fit the attributes of Dan. It's two different tribes. Nathaniel. Okay, so Benjamin is a totally different tribe. Benjamin is a totally different tribe that has totally different attributes than the Garifuna. Okay? Benjamin's a raven as a wolf. In the morning he shall devour the prey, and at night he shall divide the spoil. This is actually the Benjamin. We know throughout Benjamin's history that they used to do raid pre-dawn and dusk raids on the plantations throughout the Caribbean. This is something, and then they used to go and live in the mountains. Okay? The Garifuna didn't do this. They were exiled from their land, and they were conquered almost and subjugated by the Europeans. They were subjugated. Okay? They didn't divide up into different groups and then go and, you know, hit the different plantations. Okay? We look in Deuteronomy chapter 49. I'm sorry, chapter 33. Benjamin, the beloved of Yahweh, shall dwell and safely between him, cover him all the day long, dwell between his shoulders. That doesn't fit the Garifuna. They was all over the place. They wasn't dwelling in specific places. And the beloved of the Lord, the Wad, or they don't connect to David. Benjamin connects to David through his singing. Every Benjamin artist has songs. Just about every Benjamin artist has a song that comes from the Book of Psalms, which is written by the beloved of the Most High, which is David. Whether it's Psalm 61 or Psalms 24 or Psalms 23, all right? A lot of them sing songs coming from, they sing the Psalms of the Bible, all right? So Dan doesn't do that. The Garifuna don't do that. Okay, the Garifuna don't do that. They don't sing those types of songs. They make up their own song. Only reason that Benjamin does that is because he was introduced to English through slavery. And from slavery, he learned about himself in the scriptures, you know, and then started to sing about these songs that we can identify with as praise and also as cultural outlets and cries for freedom. Okay, but the tribe of Dan, the Garifuna, they sing their own song. They have a history and a legacy of songs that goes back more than 300 years. Benjamin, the West Indies don't have that. So this is not like this is the tribe of Benjamin, but they're just so unique, so different, and have so different of a historical experience than the other Benjamites have, the other West Indies have, or West Indians. It's not like that. They're a totally different people, and if you ask them, if you talk to them, if you ever around them, it's a whole different connection that they have with you than you have with a Benjamite. It's on a dip. Nathaniel.
Yeah.
He blowing.
Okay.
Get his phone to him. You might want to give him a call real quick. It's coming to you now. Okay, so it's a whole different vibration. It's a whole different energy. They project themselves and they conduct themselves in a different way. Their mannerisms, their spirit, okay, is different. Their upbringing of their children is different. Okay, it's different. Their music is different. Their foods are different. And not to mention the fact that these brothers are all throughout the Central America. Now, when you go into some place like Nicaragua, they're going to make a distinction between the black people there that are from Jamaica ancestry and the black people there that are from indigenous or Garifuna ancestry. They make that distinction. Everywhere you go makes that distinction. Okay? Makes that distinction because they don't just come from one place. Trinidad is there. Guyana is there. Dominica is there. Antigua is there. St. Thomas is there, okay? St. Lucia is there. But all of those theirs, the Garifuna were there before the white man or the black man came from Europe and West Africa. They were already there. Everybody understand what I'm saying? They were already there, embedded into that indigenous culture, a part of the indigenous culture, speaking the indigenous language, with indigenous habits. And then they brought the slaves from West Africa into these places. And the black ones, they said, no, we got to take them off and put them someplace else. And that's what they did. The black Caribs, they took them and put them to another island. They left the light-skinned ones on the island. And then that's when they got the whole light and dark divide and conquer plan into operation again. You understand? But there was already lighter Indians there, so-called indigenous people, which are the tribe of Dan, was already there. Now, let's suppose the black people, let's give the benefit of the doubt, okay? Let's say, okay, black people are black people that are Garifuna Indians, Garinagu, whatever you want to call them, they are the tribe of Benjamin. Let's say that, for example, for argument's sake, okay? Anybody with me? So I'm not saying that they are, but I'm saying, what if they are? Now, what's the problem we still have? Well, what problem do we still have now? No, not. Let's say they do. Let's say these black Indians or these black people are the tribe of Dan. You know what? I was wrong. My bad. They are the tribe of Dan. What's the problem now we got? They're the tribe of Benjamin. These black people, Garifuna, Garinagu, they are the tribe of Benjamin. Let's suppose that I'm wrong and they aren't the tribe of Dan. Let's suppose that they are the tribe of Benjamin. What problem now do we still have?
Who's Dan?
No, we have an immediate problem. Not who's Dan. Let's suppose there is no Dan. Let's suppose Dan is done away with. Like, let's suppose the tribe of Dan is done away with. They got absorbed into the other tribes. And what we read in Revelation chapter 20 and in Ezekiel chapter 48 about the 12 gates and Dan being one of the 12 gates and Dan having a territory. Matter of fact, Dan being the first territory mentioned in the book of Ezekiel chapter 48. Let's pretend that that's not there. Let's suppose that Dan is not mentioned as having inheritance in the new kingdom, okay? Let's pretend that. What immediately pressing problem do we still have? Think. No. We have another problem. Why does the scripture say Dan shall judge himself as one of the tribes of Israel? Because it's a red and black Caribs. So therein lies your answer. So what's the problem we got? No, that's not the problem. What's the problem?
Who are the... What's dividing them?
No, that's not the problem. What's the problem we have now? Let's suppose that the black Caribs are the tribe of Benjamin. You know what? They are Benjamin. What's the problem? Who are the red Caribs? You still got red Caribs. Nathaniel. Did you call him? He blew again.
All right.
So the red Caribs, right? Oh, that's a Benjamin hat. So what's the problem now? The problem is, who are the red Caribs, right? Who are these Indian people, these indigenous people, that still live in Trinidad, that still live in Dominica, that are still in Guyana? Let's leave off Guyana. Okay, let's say that they're Asher. That are still in Dominica. Who are the Kalipuna? Who are the the Kalipuno and the... Kalinago? What is it? Kiko? No, not them. Not the Luquillo, but the other one.
Kalinago?
The Kalipuna and the Kalinago. Who are they? Who are they? You still got Indian people that still occupy the Eastern Caribbean islands. Who are they now? Okay? Who are they? So you still have somebody that's unaccounted for. Okay, you still got people that's unaccounted for that aren't on anybody's 12 tribe sign. The 12 tribe sign that we've been using doesn't say the Indians in Trinidad, even though Trinidad has reservations where Indians live at. It doesn't say the Indians in Dominica. Even though Dominica has Indians that still live there unto this day. All throughout the Eastern Caribbean, you have these small pockets of people that were already there before the white man got there that did not do anything to fulfill the prophecies about Benjamin. So who are they now? They're not Asher. They're not... In other words, you can't say this is Asher, that's Naphtali, this is Zebulun, this is Issachar, this is Manasseh, this is Levi, this is Simeon, this is Ephraim, this is Reuben, this is Gad and Judah, okay? This is Benjamin, okay? This is Naphtali, I got Asher, Zebulun, and then you still got these people over here. What about them? You still got people in the Eastern Caribbean that's not accounted for on the 12 tribes. And you also have a tribe of Dan being mentioned as a part of the inheritance in the new kingdom with land that's not mentioned on the signs either. So it's basic mathematics. One missing people plus one missing tribe that the scriptures say is going to be in a new kingdom equals the Eastern Caribbean people, the indigenous people in the Eastern Caribbean, still have to be the tribe of Benjamin because their story is still the same with or without black people. You understand? The story is still the same because the migration history that they tell in the history that we get from Stanford University, okay? The history we get from Stanford University, which is based on indigenous history,